Friends, today I am going to discuss the extra chromosomal inheritance or extra nuclear inheritance. Otherwise, it is called cytoplasmic inheritance. One more heading also I am going to discuss, that is the atavism. First, we will see what is meant by extra chromosomal inheritance or extra nuclear inheritance. Otherwise, it is called cytoplasmic inheritance. Why the name is extra nuclear? We all know that the DNA is universal genetic material. Genes are located in the chromosomes. Genes are located in the chromosomes. We are very familiar about this. Genes are located in the chromosomes that controls the characters. This follows the Mendelian inheritance. Mendelian inheritance. When the genes are located in the chromosomes, their inheritance follows the Mendelian inheritance. But today's heading is extra nuclear inheritance. That means here, if you see this word cytoplasmic inheritance, genes which are present in the chloroplast and mitochondria. Chloroplast and the mitochondrial genes. The genes which are present in the chloroplast and mitochondria governs the character. Certain traits are trait character or traits. Certain traits are governed by the genes which are present in the chloroplast and the mitochondria. That is why chloroplast DNA and the mitochondrial DNA. In this DNA, the genes which are located control the certain characters or traits of a plant. That is why it is called extra nuclear, not in the chromosome. The genes which are present in the chloroplast DNA and mitochondrial DNA, that is why it is called extra nuclear inheritance. Do not follow the Mendelian inheritance. Mendelian inheritance. It will not follow the Mendelian inheritance. Only the genes which are located in the chromosomes, they follow the Mendelian inheritance. But the genes which are present in the chloroplast DNA and mitochondrial DNA, which will not follow the Mendelian inheritance. That is why the chloroplast and the mitochondrial DNA in certain cytoplasmic organelles DNA maintains this character, certain characters. That is why it is called the cytoplasmic inheritance. This is it is based on the plasmogene. Very important term is plasmogene. These are independent, self-replicating units. Independent, self-replicating units, that is called plasmogene, which are present in the chloroplast DNA and mitochondrial DNA. Now we are going to see the example 4 o'clock plant Mirabilis jalapa, in that how this chloroplast DNA maintaining a character, that we will see now. In 4 o'clock plant Mirabilis jalapa, we are going to see the chloroplast inheritance. In this plant there are two types of variegated leaved plants. Variegated means two different types of leaves. See here, pale green. You imagine this is the pale green leaved plant and this is the dark green leaved plant. Pale green leaved plant and this is the dark green leaved plant. Here, in the pale green leaved plant, male is taken. Dark green leaved plant, female is taken. Another type is dark green leaved plant, male is taken. Here female is taken for a dark green leaved plant. But here, for the dark green leaved plant, male is taken. And for the pale green leaved plant, female is taken. And F1, dark green leaved plant here. And here, pale green leaved plant here. But it is not following the Mendelian inheritance. In F1 generation, in Mendelian inheritance, both should be same. But in this reciprocal cross, here it F1 is gets differ. Why the difference means, I will explain you. Here pale green leaved plant male, dark green leaved plant female. When they are crossed, the F1 is dark green leaved plant because it is inheriting the character of the female plant. If you see here, dark green leaved plant male, pale green leaved plant female. What happened to the F1? It is inheriting the character of the female plant. You have to see the female only. Why it is not following the male? Why the male character is not being obtained? Means because chloroplast inheritance. See the heading, chloroplast inheritance. Here the pollen of the male plant is landing on the stigma of the female plant. Here dark green leaved plant uptight after the crossing is over. Here pollen of the dark green leaved plant landing on the stigma of the pale green leaved plant. So the F1 is pale green leaved plant. The reason is, if you see the fertilization, the male contribute only the nucleus. Keep it clearly in your mind. Male contributes only nucleus, sperm nucleus, already I told you. Female contributes egg, in that cytoplasm also present. Egg and this cytoplasm. In this cytoplasm only, chloroplast DNA only determining this character. That is why the female character is obtained in the F1 generation. Here also the female character is obtained in the F1 generation, not the male character, because the male pollen only contributing the nucleus. Both, in both the cases. But here female contribute the cytoplasm. In that cytoplasm only the chloroplast DNA is present. This DNA only responsible for the formation of the chloroplast here. That is why the dark green leaved plant is produced here, because of the female sex, because of the chloroplast DNA present in the cytoplasm of the female. Students, the next topic which I am going to explain, the mitochondrial DNA, how it is being inherited in the plants. In mitochondrial inheritance, the male sterility, see the term male sterility, is found in pearl maize, that is sorghum vulgare. Their botanical name is sorghum vulgare, pearl maize. In this maize, there are two types are there. One plant with normal cytoplasm. that is N. N indicates the normal cytoplasm. Another plant with aberrant cytoplasm, that is S, that indicates the S term. The character is not transferred through the genes which are present in the nucleus. Instead of that, this character, the male sterility character, is transferred through the mitochondrial DNA. The genes which are located in the mitochondrial DNA only, through this only the character, the male sterility, is transferred. It is transferred maternally, that means through the female plant. This character is transferred through the female plant. Already I told you why through the female plant means the cytoplasm of the female plant, cytoplasm of the female plant consists of this mitochondrial DNA only. This character is followed, this male sterility. Here also the reciprocal cross is maintained here. See here, there are two types, already I told you there are two types of cytoplasm, one with normal cytoplasm and another with aberrant, that means abnormal. Aberrant means abnormal cytoplasm, abnormal cytoplasm. The plant with normal cytoplasm, we have taken here male plant, normal. Plant with aberrant cytoplasm, female. That means yes. If you see the F1 individual, here male sterile plant. Even though the male plant came, see here male is normal only here. Plant with normal cytoplasm, male. But F1 male is sterile. Why this F1 male is sterile? Because the character is transferred through maternally. That means from the female plant, the character is being transferred. When you see the female plant, it consists of the abnormal cytoplasm. That is why the male sterility is maintained in the F1 generation. If you see here, this cross, plant with the aberrant cytoplasm, here it cannot be act as a male since the male is sterile in nature because of the aberrant cytoplasm. Plant with the normal cytoplasm can be female, N, but here the cross is not possible because of the aberrant nature of the cytoplasm of the male. Automatically it will become sterile in nature. Because of the sterility, there is no cross is followed here. So the cross is not possible. I think it is clear for you. Recently, some other plants also, the plant species also consists of this character. That means the male sterility character is seen in the other species also. Other species of plants also it is found. The male sterility is not only controlled by the mitochondrial DNA and also the nuclear gene. Restores of fertility. So this is very important term. Restores of fertility gene is present in the nuclear gene, and this male sterility gene is located in the mitochondria. When this gene will be active means this restored gene, when the sterility is found in male plant or female plant, whatever it may be, the sterility when it is there, then only this RF gene will become active. So it will become fertile in nature. Are you able to understand? There are two genes influence this character. Recently it has been discovered. Not only the genes which are found in the mitochondria, and also the nuclear gene also. So two genes influence a character. One is mitochondrial gene and another one is the nuclear gene. This nuclear gene will not express its character until when they are having the abnormal cytoplasm, aberrant cytoplasm. When the aberrant cytoplasm is there, definitely the sterility will be produced. In this case, this restore of fertility, see the name itself you can understand, restore of fertility gene is combined with this and the sterility will be stopped, it will become fertile in nature. Are you clear? There are two types of genes. One is mitochondrial gene and also the nuclear gene. Both are influencing a character. Here, in the normal condition, normal cytoplasm, the restore of fertility gene will not express. But when they are in the aberrant condition, when the sterility is there, this RF gene will become active so that the sterility will be stopped. It will become fertile. This is recently found out, this one. Students, now we are going to see the atavism. Atavism means modification of a biological structure of an ancestral triad reappears after having been lost through evolutionary changes in the previous generation. Why I have written this definition means, in your book it is given half of the definition, not complete definition. That is why I have given the complete definition here. Atavism is a modification of a biological structure in which the ancestral triad reappears after having been lost through evolutionary changes in the previous generation. For certain one character, here one character appears. This character, after that means at least five generation. For example only I am telling you, five generation, this particular character is not appeared in the next generations. At least five generations it is not appearing. Again, this is the ancestor. Ancestor means what? The persons who lived before us. That is four or five generations before us, they lived. So the ancestral character, again it reappears here due to some mutational changes or some changes which occurs in the genes. All of a sudden, the characters which disappears here, again it reappears here. After certain generations, it reappears here. That is called atavism. See here, ancestral triad reappears after having been lost. Here it is lost. It is not appeared in the next generation, next generation, next generation. It is not appeared. Then again, lost through evolutionary changes in the previous generation. After having lost through the evolutionary changes, again, it reappears here in this case. The best example for atavism is Heraceum pilosella. See here, Heraceum pilosella. It is a flowering plant. Flowering plant with lemon yellow color flower. If you see here, why this Heraceum pilosella is given as example for the atavism means, the character of sexual reproduction appears suddenly. They follow the asexual reproduction by vegetative method through through stolon. The sexual reproduction occurs when the favorable condition occurs. During that time, they will follow the sexual reproduction. That is why this Hieracium pylocella is given as example for atavism. Students, I hope you might have understood the cytoplasmic inheritance and as well as the atavism. If you have any doubts, you can ask your doubts in the comment section so that now and then I can clear your doubts. Study well. Thank you very much.